Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. A couple of months ago, I uploaded a video about the SDS program, the Student Direct Stream program, which is the fastest visa related to IRCC. Okay, and they give you an approval within 20 days in most cases. So, SDS, they have recently updated or rather upgraded their system. Okay, previously they had a few countries on their list. I will show you in a couple of minutes. And now they have increased this list, and now SDS is available to so many countries that are that will be shared later in this video. Okay, so now let me tell you what is SDS. It is basically the student direct stream. Okay, either you get a study permit or you get a SDS. Okay, so SDS is for few countries, and if you're living in those countries, then only you can apply for SDS. Okay, and if you are living in rest of the world, then you apply for a study permit. So basically one thing and another, these are the same things, only difference is that SDS processing time is at the speed of light. Like within 20 days they either approve your case or reject your case. So for SDS, you need a few things. First of all, obviously, acceptance letter from your university or college, proof of payment for the first year's fee to your university or college. Okay, then a $10,000 GIC, that is guaranteed investment certificate, maybe that is the acronym. Okay, $10,000 GIC. Then you need to submit a nice, well-written SOP, okay? And most consultants, they have ghostwriters, okay? These are people who write for money, like freelance content writers. These are ghostwriters who write your SOP, okay? So you, if you know English well enough, if you have scored like 7.5 bands in writing, then obviously you are well equipped to write your SOP, and you can use Grammarly plugin to so that you make sure there are no mistakes. Okay, but you have to convey your intentions, and you have to convey your what is up with your application for study permit. Okay, that is what's written in the SOP. That is 2-3 pages letter. I mean, if your case is like that, you should write 2-3 pages of an SOP, okay, and submit that PDF along with your application, okay. And then there are some other requirements, like you have to have your IELTS result in your hand, okay. You have to have medicals, upfront medicals, maybe that is the requirement for some programs, upfront medicals. And you have to pay the fee for SDS, okay? And you can also pay the biometric fee, and then they will give you a BIL, okay? So these are the basic requirements for SDS, but nonetheless, your university admission is different, okay? You pick a DLI, Designated Learning Institute, and that DLI will give you admission, okay? But that admission is not a visa, okay? For visa, you need a study permit, or if your country falls into this category that I'm going to share, then you would apply to SDS, the Student Direct Stream. Okay, so universities give you admission, visa officer give you visa. So universities requirements are quite easy, because they want your fee and they want you to study in their university. But visa officer, he needs a lot of satisfaction and a lot of convincing, okay, to give you a visa, a study permit, okay, or rather the student direct stream study visa, okay. And here are the few countries that are updated to the SDS stream, as you can see on your screen right now. Previously, there were like 7 countries that were already in the SDS stream, like China, India, Morocco, Pakistan, Philippines, and Vietnam, and another country. Okay, so now they have updated the list, and I would name all the countries that now have SDS, which I briefly talked about in the introduction of the video. Antigua and Barbuda, that is probably West Indies, I mean, I'm not sure. Okay, Brazil. Okay, the country of Ronaldo, the original Ronaldo. China, obviously everybody knows about China. Colombia, Costa Rica, these are maybe South American countries, I'm not sure. Okay, India, Morocco, Pakistan, Peru, again a South American country probably. Okay, Philippines, Senegal, Saint Vincent and the Grenadines Okay, and second last is Trinidad and Tobago. That is against West Indies and Vietnam. So now these are the countries. They have updated their website. Okay, IRCC has made this SDS program available to these countries as well. And I have briefly talked about the eligibility criteria. If you have any questions, then obviously you can always come to this website, SDSCanada.ca. That is the official website. Okay, so you can always come to this web page and find out about the requirements. Okay, and medical is actually medical test. Something I missed. Medical test is needed in a few countries. Okay, so if you find this list here, right here, designated countries or territories. So it will tell you basically that you need an upfront medical examination or not. For example, countries like Afghanistan, you would need a medical. Okay, so countries like Albania, you wouldn't need it. Algeria, you would need it. So you can find your country right here, and you would be able to basically find out if you need a medical exam. Okay, so this was all about the latest IRCC update about the SDS program. This is Alif Takhar, and I strongly suggest that you should look into the SDS program if you cannot make enough CRS.